Good morning, dear students. Today we are going to revise Making of a Scientist. So here we begin. This article is an account of a curious child channelizing his curiosity to become a scientist. Ebright was a highly curious child since his childhood. His mother, his only companion during childhood, helped the further deepening his curiosity. Ebright began his journey by collecting butterflies. After that, he worked on tagging the monarch butterflies so that the scientists' community could be benefited. Later on, he did research on utility of gold spots on pupa to monarch butterflies. He became famous when his paper on working of cell was published in a scientific journal. Ebright participated in many science exhibitions, but winning an award for the sake of winning was never his goal. He participated in those exhibitions because he wanted to do a task as best as that could be done. Let's have the story in detail. The Making of a Scientist is the story about the famous scientist Richard Ebright. Richie, as his mother used to call him, was a very curious child right from his childhood. He had started collecting butterflies in his childhood, and when he was 2 years old, he had already collected all the 25 species found near his hometown. He thought it to be an end of butterfly collection until one day his mother bought him a book named The Travel of Monarch X. This was a turning point in his life, and he got much more interested in dealing with science. He started with tagging butterflies, which a task given at the end of the book that his mother bought for him. Then when he first entered the country science fair with a slide of the frog tissue, he lost. Everybody won something but his project. You can see in that competition, that science competition, because he had presented only a slideshow of frog tissues. He didn't do any sort of proper experiment. That's why he lost. He did not win any prize. He was sad, but also understood that to win, he needed to do real experiments and not just make neat and clean models. Then he wrote down to Dr. Yukart at the University of Toronto, asking him for ideas to make projects. He stayed busy during his high school working on the long list sent to him by Dr. Yukart. Then for the next year's fair, he chose the project of looking at the viral disease that killed nearly all the monarch caterpillars every few years. He thought that the reason for this could be a beetle. So he started raising caterpillars in the presence of beetles, but could not get any results. So when he showed his trial experiment at the country science fair, his project won a prize. Then for the next year, he made an experiment to show that the viscerae butterflies copied monarch. This project also made him win prizes. Then he started his another projects. See, you can see, dear children, in real life we also had to face many time lot many defeats. We lost battles, meaning challenges of life, but these challenges are also teaching us many things. Success is to celebrate, but defeats are to understand. And if we understand from our defeats, then definitely nobody will be able to check. Nobody will be able to stop our journey of success. This is the role of defeat in our life. Then he, that also win him prizes. Then he started his research as to the purpose of the 12 golden spots on the back of a monarch pupa. Everybody believed that it was just a design, but Dr. Yukart thought otherwise. Then a bright and another brilliant science student got together and made a device that could show that the gold spots were responsible for releasing a hormone that was necessary for its growth. With the help of sophisticated instruments at one of the labs, he got a chance to work and found the chemical structure of the hormone in the gold spots. Then one day, while looking at the photo of the chemical structure, he solved one of the biggest puzzles of life. He came to know how a cell blueprints its DNA. It was a big breakthrough and was published in a magazine. He also had many other interests and also admired his social studies teacher, as he was the dear children. Many times your teachers are telling you that the subjects are interrelated. One subject is correlated with another. Here you can say, making of a scientist, a bright became scientist. His real taste for science was there, but he thanked his social science teacher as well. Why? Because that teacher only motivated him. Social sciences only motivated him for his science project as well. His social studies teacher, as he was the one who used to give him new ideas. He was good at debating, public speaking, and a great pianist. He never used to win for the sake of winning or for prizes, but because he wanted to be the best at whatever he used to do. It is shown in this chapter that with the right amount of curiosity, a bright mind, and the will to win, for right reasons, are the qualities needed to be a scientist. His mother also played a big role in making him what he was, as it was she who supported him throughout his journey and brought him the book, The Travel of Monarch Eggs, which aroused his curiosity in the field of science. See, dear children, he was able to become a scientist because of the book. Curiosity was always there in him, but this book upgraded that curiosity. It enhanced that curiosity in him, and that is why he was able to become a great scientist.